On October 17th, a little over a week after these people were arrested for preparing to kidnap Gretchen Whitmer, Trump riled up a boisterous crowd in Muskegon with more slashing personal attacks on Whitmer, driving the crowd to chant, "Lock her up, lock her up." He had now seen that some of his followers were prepared to engage in criminal violence with orchestrated attacks, deadly weapons, and willing bodies to storm a state capitol building and to attack his perceived political enemies. And so as the crowd chanted, "Lock her up," he pivoted to his next goal. He told them they couldn't trust the governor to administer fair elections in Michigan. He used a crowd that he knew would readily engage in violence to prepare his followers for his next and, of course, his paramount political objective, claiming the election was stolen and inciting insurrectionary action. And he did it again on October 27th during a pre-election rally speech in Lansing, Michigan, where the Capitol had been stormed. Trump openly joked with the crowd about critics saying his words had provoked the violent plot against Governor Whitmer. Check it out, it's telling.
"We gotta get her going. I don't think she likes me too much. See, I don't comment on that, because every time if I make just even a little bit of a nod, they say, the president led them on. No, I don't have to lead you on. Even a little nod, they say, the president said, your governor, at the urging of her husband, who has abused our sister very badly, the only man allowed in the state of Michigan, the only man allowed to go sailing is her husband. No, your governor, I don't think she likes me too much. Hey, 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 I'm the one, it was our people that helped her out with her problem. I mean, we'll have to see if it's a problem, right? People are entitled to say maybe it was a problem, maybe it was our people, my people, our people, that helped her out."
So President Trump offered them a little winking inside joke about his constant incitement of the mob and how much can actually be communicated by him with just a little nod, just a little nod. He presided over another pounding, rhythmic rendition of his trademark chant, "Lock her up, lock her up." Then, referring to the FBI's foiling of the kidnapping conspiracy, which was deadly serious, he said that he helped her out with a problem. Maybe it was a problem, maybe it wasn't. We'll have to see. Maybe it was a problem, maybe it wasn't. The President of the United States of America. He could not bring himself to publicly oppose a kidnapping and potential assassination conspiracy plot against a sitting governor of one of our 50 states. Trump knew exactly what he was doing in inciting the January 6th mob. Exactly. He had just seen how easily his words and actions inspired violence in Michigan. He sent a clear message to his supporters. He encouraged planning and conspiracies to take over Capitol buildings and threaten public officials who refused to bow down to his political will. Is there any chance Donald Trump was surprised by the results of his own incitement? Let's do what Tom Paine told us to do. Use our common sense, the sense we have in common as citizens. If we don't draw the line here, what's next? What makes you think the nightmare with Donald Trump and his lawmaking and violent mobs is over? If we let him get away with it, and then it comes to your state capitol, or it comes back here again, what are we going to say? These prior acts of incitement cast a harsh light on Trump's obvious intent. Obvious intent. His unavoidable knowledge of the consequences of his incitement. The unavoidable knowledge of the consequences of his incitement and the clear foreseeability of the violent harm that he unleashed on our people and our republic. January 6th was not some unexpected radical break from his normal law-abiding and peaceful disposition. This was his state of mind. This was his essential MO.